Diego Martin celebrated some of its cultural icons today through the Hall of Fame initiative, honoring publicly those who call the area home in some way or the other. The initiative, which was born out of an existing project funded by the Commonwealth Foundation, involved a research exercise in which youth in the area were tasked with selecting icons which they thought needed to be highlighted. At the unveiling of the project on Friday, the program officer pointed out the need for the upcoming generation to pay homage to those who have dedicated their lives to country. Janine Brown has more.
Cultural icons all selected by the youth themselves to be displayed here at the Hall of Fame.
The Hall of Fame initiative is grounded in an already existing project, fostering a democratic culture in schools and local communities, which has been funded by the Commonwealth Foundation. The Hall of Fame project required students to conduct research on great cultural icons emerging from or who have some connection to Diego Martin, which they would like to honor. Among those selected, Calypsonians, the Mighty Sparrow and the Mighty Chalk Dust, Miss Universe 1998 Wendy Fitzwilliams, and author Paul Keynes Douglas. Sandra Singh, who represents the Commonwealth Foundation, explained the training the students underwent for the duration of the program.
The young people would have been trained in the principles of governance and democracy. They would have been imparted with knowledge and skills in communication. And they were also allowed to contribute towards the cultural development of the communities.
But she pointed out students were also taught the importance of heroes who wear their capes outside of the spotlight.
We are at a stage where our cultural heroes, probably there's focus on those who have made it nationally and internationally in terms of recognition. But what about the local heroes? You would have heard Ruby Dee talk. What about the community midwife, for example? Isn't that a regional, a local hero?
Ms. Singh is seen here with the chairman of the Diego Martin Regional Corporation, Susan Hong, admiring the end result of the children's hard labor. And today is just the beginning. Under the leadership of the Trinidad and Tobago Association of Local Government Authority, the initiative will be adopted in the 13 other municipal corporations.
A project that would be sustained by the local authority. So we've positioned the local government authority now, and in this case, the Diego Martin Regional Corporation, to take the project forward.
At a regional level, Guyana, St. Lucia, and the Bahamas are also conducting similar initiatives. Janine Brown, CNews.